knowing about the Vijayanagar and Bahamani kingdoms. Now, these two kingdoms were located in southern India, and the most interesting part about it was during the time there was the Tughlaq dynasty in the north. We have seen the Muhammad bin Tughlaq was one of the major rulers in Delhi when Vijayanagar dynasty was founded, and during this time there was a significant decline in the Tughlaq successors, and this has led to a significant impact on the organization of the kingdoms and the states. As a result, the North India was divided into smaller states: Delhi, Jaunpur, Odisha, Kashmir, then we have Malwa, Mewar, and in the south, Deccan became a separate entity. So in the Deccan, we had two important kingdoms that we would be studying, and those are the Vijayanagar kingdom and the Bahamani kingdom. Now, the most interesting fact here to understand is the Vijayanagar kingdom was located in the southernmost India, and Mysore and Chennai were the two important centers under Vijayanagar Empire. However, under Bahamani kingdom, we had Bijapur, Gulbarg, Golconda as some of the major towns, and this was located north of the Vijayanagar kingdom. The region between these two was further interesting. It was known as the Raichur Duab. Now, Duab is a region where you have two rivers flowing across the region, and the region lying in between the two rivers is usually a fertile area. So Duab is a fertile region, and we had Krishna and its tributary Tungabhadra, between which the Raichur Duab is situated. Therefore, this Duab was one of the most fertile areas, which you can see in blue color here. And this was a main bone point of contention, considering the fact that sometimes this was falling under the Bahamani kingdom, sometimes under the Vijayanagar Empire. So there was constant conflicts regarding the acquisition or the annexing of the Raichur Duab. Now, coming on to the major capitals. So the capital of Vijayanagar was Hampi, and the capital of Bahamani was Gulbarg. Now, Bahamani kingdom came into existence a little later than the Vijayanagar Empire. Vijayanagar Empire established itself in 1336 and lasted for nearly 230 years. The north of it, the Bahamani kingdom, came a little later in 1347 around, and then it lasted for nearly 180 years. So there was a significant difference that was seen in the two kingdoms and the empires that were there. So when we need to understand the power, we understand how the developments took place. So under Vijayanagar, we had numerous kingdoms and the numerous kings that were there. It was initially founded by two brothers, Harihar and Bukka Rai, and the same time Bahamani kingdom was founded by Hasan Gangu. Hasan Gangu later on named himself Alauddin Hasan Shah Bahamani. Now, in the Bahamani kingdom, one of the major persons that we study in the history is Mahmud Gawan. Now, Mahmud Gawan's role is very, very important. He was a wazir in the kingdom of Muhammad Shah III, and during his time, Bahamani kingdom was in best of its powers, we could say. And later on, after his death, he died in 1481. And later on, after his death, the Bahamani kingdom started to lose its good successors, and as a result, in 1527, this was the time when in the Vijayanagar Empire, you had Krishnadev Rai as one of the leaders, and during this time, the Bahamani kingdom started to dissociate. So it dissociated into five small kingdoms, and those are the Bijapur, the Bidar, Golconda, and then you have the Ahmednagar and the Bijapur. Now, what we need to understand here is this dissociation was the time where in the south you had Vijayanagar dynasty, and here Krishnadev Rai was in power. Krishnadev Rai is considered to be one of the major kings of the Vijayanagar dynasty, and his power and supremacy was well established. During his reign from 1509 to 1530, he won various battles, and Finally, he also witnessed during his time the disintegration of the Bahamani kingdom. However, the successors of Krishnadev Rai were not that strong. And finally, under the Battle of Talikota, there was a complete decay of the power of the Vijayanagar Empire by the five combined forces from the north, the Deccan Sultans. So the five Deccan Sultans that divided themselves came together, and finally there was the victory of the five Deccan Sultans as a combined force in the region of Vijayanagar, and Vijayanagar was annexed. Now, if we talk about some of the major marvels of the Bahamani and the Vijayanagar kingdom, under the Bahamani kingdom, we had Chand Minar at Bidar, then we have Jama Masjid at Gulbarg and Gol Gumbaj at Bijapur as some of the major features that have been seen. Now, Gol Gumbaj is known for its architectural marvel, for its acoustic system, which we would understand in detail in our section on Bahamani kingdoms. When it comes to Vijayanagar Empire, three important temples which were classic examples of Vijayanagar dynasty are the Hazara Ram temple. Now, this was a temple within the royal enclosure and was considered as a private chapel for the kings. The next was the Vitthal Swami temple. Vitthal Swami temple was known for Lord Vishnu. And then you had the Virupaksh temple, which was known for Lord Shiva. So those were some of the major marvels of the Vijayanagar kingdom. Coming on to the kind of conflict, as we said. Now, there were various points of conflicts between Bahamani and Vijayanagar Empire. Some of the common points, the most common one as we understood, was the Raichur Dwab. Now, Raichur Dwab, as we said, was a fertile land between the Krishna and the Tungabhadra, Tungabhadra tributary of Krishna. And this was always in conflict between the attacks from the north, the Deccan Sultans, and the Vijayanagar kingdoms trying to protect it. Then the western coast, we had the Konkan coast, and here a lot of Portuguese sailors were coming in. Domingo and Nunes were two of the main Portuguese who visited this region, and the most interesting fact is they built numerous fortresses and palaces in this region. They provided the Vijayanagar Empire with numerous arms, ammunition, and kind of architectural layouts that were helpful. So Vijayanagar dynasty had good relations with Portuguese travelers who were coming in. Now, besides this, the region between the Godavari and the Krishna River was again a point of contention between the Bahamani and Vijayanagar Empire. And besides this, Golconda mines. Now, Golconda mines were known for its diamond mining, and therefore was another point of conflict between the two states that were there. Now, the last important thing that we need to understand is how the disintegration occurred. So, as we said, there was the Battle of Talikota in 1565. Now, from 1527, the Bahamani Empire started to dissociate into five small kingdoms. And those, as we said, were the regions of Bidar, the regions of Golconda, the regions of Ahmednagar. Then you have Bijapur and Berar. So those were the five different regions that were divided. Now these five sultans of these five kingdoms came together against the Vijayanagar Empire. And during that time, in the Vijayanagar Empire, there was Alia Ram Rai, and Alia Ram Rai was executed. So this whole region was annexed by the combined forces of the Deccan, and with this, the Vijayanagar Empire came to an end. Similarly, in the north, when there was the Bahamani kingdom, as we said, Mahmud Gawan was one of the major leaders, and with the declining power of Mahmud Gawan and the death of Mahmud Gawan in 1481, the Bahamani kingdom collapsed. Now, this was much before the collapse of Vijayanagar kingdom, but Vijayanagar lost its existence because of the combined attack from the Deccan Sultans. Now, who were the major sultans during that time were again important. So, Bidar was under Bidar Shahi. Then you have Berar under Imad Shahi, Bijapur under Adil Shahi, Ahmednagar under Nizam Shahi, and Golconda under Qutub Shahi. So these were the five important leaders, the five important kings during that time. Now finally, why there was the decline of the Tughlaq dynasty in the north. So as we saw, during the time Vijayanagar dynasty established in the south, it was Muhammad bin Tughlaq ruling the Delhi, and he founded, basically he was there with the Tughlaq dynasty. But over the years, we saw a sudden decline in the Tughlaq empire. Now, what were the reasons that led to the decline of the Tughlaq empire? First was the later successors of Firoz Shah Tughlaq were very, very weak. They were not united and they were trying to overexpand their empires. In the process of overexpansion, what was happening? Each region was established under the individual governors, and these governors slowly and gradually became independent and they tried to segregate themselves from the Tughlaq empire, and therefore there was a kind of decline in the Tughlaq power. Again, a lot of invasions were seen during this time. Raids and plunders by Timur have been very, very important. Timur invaded India from the region of Samarkand, and it was during the time of 1398 that there were significant invasions of Timur that were witnessed. And also, Muhammad bin Tughlaq tried to do numerous experiments, but he became an unpopular figure with the common people, and therefore he could not his rule could not last longer. And finally, as we said, the overextension of the empire that was planned brought in numerous governors of independent states, and these governors started to rebel against the Tughlaq dynasty, and as a result they established themselves as independent leaders. So Assam, Bengal, then you have Jaunpur, Malwa, Mewar, then the Deccan region started to separate out, and it was in this process that Vijayanagar and Bahamani kingdom established themselves as a separate dynasty, as a separate empire. So this was about a general introduction on Vijayanagar and Bahamani kingdoms. We would be covering Vijayanagar and Bahamani kingdoms in detail in separate lectures. So stay tuned for further updates from our side in history. Have a wonderful day ahead.